Greetings, humans. I'm recording a little bit of a voiceover because of the noise from the highway, so you can actually understand what I'm saying. It wasn't very good in the video. Today is new bike day. It's Canyon Sender, and I'm basically swapping it for my old Canyon Torque because I no longer need to pedal, so I might as well go full downhill. For any kind of pedal use cases, I've got the titanium hardtail, so that's more than sufficient aggressive bike for anything. My old Canyon Torque has Fox 36 and X2 suspension, so it's pretty good bike, also carbon frame. Really good Doppler post. This bike is aluminum. It has SRAM GX downhill drivetrain with 7 gears. The brakes are code R, also from SRAM. I'm kind of spoiled by my Hope brakes on the titanium hardtail, so I'll be eventually swapping this away as well. I've got plenty of time to do that before the season starts, so easy. The suspension is Maserati. In the rear it's a coil spring, it's 400 pound. I will talk about that later. But more importantly, I'm not exactly happy how it arrived. It arrived with many flaws. For instance, to begin with, the brake pads and the whole, basically the whole caliper and brake disc was covered in dot fluid. The bleed port was missing the rubber cover. I think that the mechanic just forgot to like wipe it down, and why did they like even make that mess, achieve that mess, I don't know, but I didn't find anything loose or anything broken on the brakes, so that's not the issue. Then the rear hose is also a bit too long and it's rubbing basically against the stanchions from the inside, while Canyon did put a sticker there to protect the stanchions. That sticker is very small and it's like 10 centimeters away in a wrong spot, not where the rear brake hose goes. So it's absolutely useless. Another problem was that the brake calipers were completely off alignment. I spent like an hour just trying to align them. It was a real pain in the ass. I'm not surprised that they failed to align it, to be honest. It was really bad. Then this little spacer on the stem was completely squished and deformed because whoever assembled the bike previously simply didn't align it correctly and it got deformed. Oh, suspension test. A little bit of a staircase thingy. Oh, that was very noisy.
Was it?
Yeah, it's like no idea why. And I feel a lot of heat on the rear wheel. So we shall see. So here we can actually see that the noise was bottom out of the rear suspension. And the little plasticky mudguard is actually hitting the seat clamp in this exact frame. So I thought that the 400 pound spring will actually be way too much for me, which it probably would be in regular bike park or trails and stuff. I have turned down all the preload as far as possible according to the manual. We are at minimum, basically. And I'm pretty close to recommended sag. The ideal spring for me would be probably 375. This is 400. However, coil spring is actually very linear suspension. So that means that basically it's not gonna work well in big hits like this. Like this is what a meter and a half basically hit to flat. You don't do that on a trail. You have always a downslope, so the it would be very gradual. From a drop of even higher height would be much less force. I went off of this drop. This thing fell off, broken straight. I don't know. I mean, this is E13, but I don't know if Canyon did something wrong. It's broken sheared straight off. Wee! Longer! We have to go longer. Now go up there, turn around and come back. You have to turn as well. You have to like drift sideways. Here, my turn.